Donc, une jeune noire. J'ai un double clip.
Can't turn your back for a second. Good morning. Well, today's live match is the first round of Anthony King's individual league. I have four rounds during March. I'm not looking at the camera because we've already started. And I've drew peg 12 on match leg, which is old peg 17. And it's one of them. Can be good. Wind's going the wrong way for you today, I'm afraid, but we'll see. I'll show you the peg. I've cast out. So I'm sitting on the maggot feeder. I've cast out to the just off the point of that island. To me right, I've got Alan Dewhurst. Gives away, Val. Alan Dewhurst on the end peg. And panning around the other side. I've got Gibbo on my left. It's every peg in. And then Jake Robinson on the end peg. If you remember the last time I filmed a live match at Erenbrook, he was on the end peg that day as well. What's that tell you? Anyway, I don't expect to beat him or the end peg on the opposite side, but it's 12 peg section, so the whole lake is a section, and then there's six for the money, and the league's run out of a section point, so it's not a brilliant draw, but it's artificial, so we'll give it a go. Like I said, this is the first round of King's individual league. It's run over every Sunday in March, so a four round series. And it's 12 peg sections, one for a win, 12 for last. And my first draw is on match leg 12, which is the old peg 17. I've been on this peg many a time. It's very deep. It can be a good peg. When the wind's coming up this end of the lake, it can be very good. But I did fear the worst when I got to the peg to see the wind was blowing down the other end of the lake. That normally indicates there's not a lot of fish up there, but we'll see. The first thing I did before I chucked the feeder was feed two lines on the pole, one at 14.5 meters and a short line. And I only fed it with a little ball on each line of match method mix. I give the feeder about half hour and never had a single indication, no liners, no nothing. So dropped on the pole, put a little nugget of ground bait in, two maggots on the hook, and the first fish I had was this roach. That wasn't a good sign.
It's a bite. Find a dry end, Paul. Oh, you're meant to be silverfish.
Little tiny nugget of ground bait into that pot. I didn't want to start by putting maggots in because it can be a nuisance early doors with all the roach and perch that's in there. There's lots of little tiny perch in there. I didn't want to start by catching those, basically. So a bit of fish meal ground bait usually stops that happening. As you can see, it didn't work. First fish I had was a roach. I still haven't fed any maggots. Dropped back in again, and I had a little tiny perch. So I've come back off that. So back on the maggot feeder to see if there's anything turned up where I'd been previously throwing. And in the meantime, I'd noticed that Alan on the next peg, he'd been pinging hard 4mm pellets onto his 14.5 meter line. Now he had a liner and then he had a fish. So this prompted me to get off my box and sort it out because I hadn't set up for this. I expected it to be a maggot day, to be honest, so caught me on the hop a bit. So I've got off my box, got some pellets out, got some Fin Perfect 4mm pellets out, and a rig. The rig was a 4x16 into wire. It's a deep peg, it's 7 foot deep. So you need a big rig to fish that effectively, especially with the wind we got again, which seems relentless all the time. To be fair, it was off our back, so it wasn't as uncomfortable as it could be. So anyway, while I'm putting the rig together, getting a hook length out, I get my first indication on the rod. It's an absolute wrap round. I'd slackened the clutch off when I got off my box to get the pellets and that out, and I forgot to turn it back on. So I've had to quickly put some more pressure on the clutch. And then continue playing the fish. It was only a little F1, a stocky size fish, but it got me off the mark. And I was hoping there was an arrival of fish there. Wasn't the biggest of fish, but very welcome. So I chucked it back out again while I was getting this rig ready and see if it would happen again. Just putting about 5 or 6 maggots in the feeder, and I'm giving a little tiny pinch between my thumb and finger of grain bait just to leave a bit of scent in the water. And chucking back out to the island, just off the point of the island, then finished off getting my rig ready. So I finished off putting that rig together and plumbing it up, and I've reeled the rod back in. I had never had another indication on it, no liners or anything. So I reeled the rod back in and fed the pellet line. I put about 10 4mm pellets in and a sprinkle of micro pellets. The camera angle's not brilliant for this line. I do move it in a bit. So while I gave that time to start doing its magic, I went on back on the maggot line, and I never had an indication on it again. So after about 5 minutes of going on the pellet, it's gone down the hole and I'm into a decent F1. I'm already glad that I saw what Alan was doing, because it's helped me catch this fish at least. And that's why it's important to watch what's going on around you. a nice F1 out of a £3. I'm rubbish at putting pellets in the band, so I always use the banding tool. And I always use the small band for my pellets. Look, was a size 18 GPMB. Put about 6 pellets in the pot there. Give it a quick dunk. It helps stick the pellets to the pot so it's non-bounce out while you're shipping out. Get to your line, turn the pole over, give it a quick tap and they all come falling out, then lay your rigging. Well, I've moved the camera angle now so you can see where I'm fishing. And I'm back into a fish again. I'm a decent stamp on this pellet as well. It's noticeable there's not a lot happening on the pool. I know Jake had got a few fish that he caught on the feeder early on. And is now catching on the pole. That I can see one more on the far bank that's catching, Paul Brandrick. But I can't see anybody else doing a lot. Paul Gibson to my left had 3 fish early on, but he's really struggling now. Alan to my right still only got the 1 fish. Marpeg's starting to come to life a bit. Have a nice little run of pellet fish. And I also started catapulting maggots over to my maggot line just to try and make something happen on that line because it was virtually dead. I had 2 fish, that roach and perch, and then I can't get a bite on it, so I can't see it hurting me feeding some maggots there, try and draw something in. If all else fails, I've got this pellet line to keep working at. And like I say, I'm an half decent stamp as well. It's by no means one a chuck, but I know it looks it in the video, but I've done a lot of editing to it. Over the next 40 minutes, I probably had 5 fish. I'm still catapulting maggots over to my right hand line, hoping that some fish will turn up on it. But I'm not going to come off this line while I'm still getting bites on it. Right, that line died off a bit, so I thought, let me another quick chuck on the feeder. This time I'm chucking directly in front of the island. Because Alan's just had a fish off the island, I thought I'd go and have a look, see if I can catch one. and I'm still catapulting pellets to my left and maggots to my right. Not many, just a few, just a pinch of pellets. And then the same with maggots over the other line. Trying to build the swims. What's important is nobody else is feeding maggots in this way. Right, never had another indication on the feeder. Can't believe that one fish I had while I was setting up that rig is the only fish I caught on the feeder the whole match. So I'm going to go and try my maggot line now. Put two maggots on the hook and I've just put 10 maggots in the pot, giving it a dunk again to help them stick to the pot so they don't bounce out. And it's either going to be Roach City or we'll catch F1s. So I'm laying the rigging first and then I'm dropping the baiting because it's a long way down. And there's already feed going through the water from when I've been catapulting. And it didn't take long. And I got a bite. In fact, it was pretty quick. I never edited that bit, so from where laying the rigging to the bite going under was actual time. And it luckily it was an F1. Let's just stop, there's a few more there. They're a bit smaller on the maggot, but I'm not bothered. I'm putting fish in the net. Two red maggots up through the thin end. I always do that. And a sprinkle of maggots in the pot. Quick dunk. And out we go. Just stops you spilling anything. I'm still catapulting over the top as well while I'm fishing this line. And I'm also still catapulting pellets to the other line. Definitely feel I did the right thing picking the catapult up and feeding that line with maggots. Last time I was on this lake, if you put a maggot in the water, you just got pestered by roach and perch. Just goes to show now 2 days are the same. It definitely needed the catapult to draw fish into the peg. Paul's cottoned on what I'm doing with the catapult and he started feeding his line with the catapult as well now. It got really good for a bit. Had a steady run of fish. They weren't massive, but very welcome. Using DuraSlip 9 elastic on both my lines today. Nice if this carried on all match. Put a decent weight together.
Don't shake your head, isn't it?
Slightly better fish this one. Getting interesting now. I'm definitely catching more than anybody around me. Shocking netting skills. One and bung at the minute. I thought if this carried on the way it was, especially with me loose feeding maggots, I might catch some fish up in the water. But I never had a single liner all day. I never had a bite on the drop or any indications when the rig was going through the water. Everything was just after the rig had settled. So they had no intentions of coming up. I'm flying now. That fudge you can hear in the background is the bird scarer, but it doesn't seem to bother the cormorants. Pouch of maggots to get the next fish lined up. It's going really steady. I'm enjoying it now. Next up was a roach. That's a sure sign that the F1s have moved out the peg for a while. So I'll leave that line alone a bit and then go back onto the pellet line. And there's a couple of fish there waiting for me. So if I can keep the two lines going, I can rotate them both throughout the match. Still feeding both lines with the catapult as well as cupping in, just to keep a bit of bait going into the peg and hopefully drawing fish into it. It's noticeable the size difference between the pellet fish and the maggot fish. They're much better quality on the pellet, but you're not getting the bites as quick. It's real good fun, this is now. And still nobody's really catching around me either. There's a couple of pegs I can see that are both doing well. Jake on the end peg and Paul Brandrick on the opposite bank. But other than them two, I can't see anybody else really catching anything. And it's warming up. Happy days. So I thought it was time to feed down the edge. When I say down the edge, I haven't gone proper into the edge. I've gone down the shelf. It's probably about four and a half feet deep where I've plumbed up. These can be good lines for the carp on this lake, if they're interested in feeding. So I'm putting a ball of ground bait and a few maggots there. And I also started feeding maggots out my hand in front of me at top 2 and 2. Hoping to get some fish short there as well. Interestingly, neither of these lines worked. Never caught on the shorter line or in the edge line. The only two lines I really caught on were the pellet long and the maggot long. So I didn't waste too much time on either of these lines when I tried them. It was just a quick look on both, just to eliminate them really. I'm back out on the pellet line. Sprinkle 4mm fin perfects and 4mm fin perfect on the hook. It wasn't manic, but there was fish to be caught. No, it's stamp F1 again. Sun's becoming a bit of a problem now. Now more bites on this line. So back out on the maggot line. To see if anything's turned up back there. You couldn't afford to waste too much time on each line, because once you'd had a little burst of fish, you wouldn't get an indication. Luckily, I had the two lines I could drop in on. I could switch between. So when one line seemed like it was devoid of fish, I could drop on the other one and usually get at least one fish. Come the end of the match, I'd fed over 2 pints of maggots, which in early March is quite a lot of bait, but it was definitely the right way to go. It did slow down towards the end of the match, but I was still able to keep the odd fish coming off either of the lines. So this was the last fish of the day. It was slow the last hour. I probably only had 4 fish in the last hour. I'd say the third and fourth hours were really good. I probably had 14 fish, which got me right up the field. Cracking days fishing, and ended up with 20 F1s plus them few little silvers. The net rules at Erenbrook now are you've got to have 3 nets in, and you've got to have your fish split between the 3 nets equally. And then after that, it's a £65 net limit. So if you go over £65, you will get knocked back to £65. It's not a problem at the minute because you're not catching that many fish. Come the summer months, you will need to take extra nets there. Because over £200 is a regular occurrence at Erenbrook. And you don't want to be falling foul of the net limits. My 20 fish weighed £40.08, which put me fourth on the lake. Like I said, Jake was always going to win the section. He had £70. Paul Brandrick on the other bank, he ended up with 50 odd. And then next to him, there was a 47, and that left me fourth. But I took the section by default because Jake actually framed in the match. Happy days. So a good start to the league. Off a peg, I didn't feel that I could do too well off, so I was well happy. Right, if you enjoyed watching that, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more like this, please subscribe. And I'll see you on the next one. Cheers.